In this video, I take a look at the alkaline hydrolysis of esters. It would in fact be better to refer to it as the alkaline catalyzed hydrolysis of esters. Where the ester is a complex ester, namely a fat or an oil, then the hydrolysis is known as saponification because it produces a soap. Let's look at a simple definition of the term hydrolysis. It can be defined as splitting a substance apart using the elements of water. The hydrolysis of an ester will bring about the formation of a carboxylic acid and an alcohol, but that carboxylic acid will go on to react with the alkali to form the salt of the acid. Let's take a look at the simplest case. I've taken the simple ester here, ethyl ethanoate, and I'm going to react it with sodium hydroxide. So when heated together, we get hydrolysis taking place first, and that will give us two products, ethanoic acid and ethanol. It essentially reverses the process that will have formed the ester from a carboxylic acid and an alcohol. And you see there, you'll get ethanoic acid plus ethanol. However, the ethanoic acid, being a weak acid, will react with the sodium hydroxide, behaving as a catalyst in the hydrolysis, to form the sodium salt. And you see here that what happens effectively is that we get the ONA of the NaOH going with the CH3CO. And there we've got CH3COONA, sodium ethanoate, the sodium salt of the acid, plus ethanol, CH3CH2OH. So that's hydrolysis of a simple ester. Let's take a look now at the hydrolysis of complex esters, namely fats and oils. And the hydrolysis here produces a soap. So I've taken glycerol tristearate, also known as tristearine. It's a triglyceride or triester. Now, as there are three ester linkages there, I'm taking this time three sodium hydroxides, 3 moles per mole of the fat. Again, I would boil or heat under reflux to bring this reaction about. And we get a similar reaction taking place. We'll end up with hydrolysis taking place, forming the fatty acids, which will then react with the sodium hydroxide in a simple weak acid strong alkali reaction to form the salt of the acids. And I'll also get the alcohol, the triol glycerol, properly known as propane 1,2,3 triol. That's its structure. And then we're getting the sodium salt of the fatty acid. The fatty acid present there is stearic acid. And you can see there that I've got 3 moles of sodium stearate produced. And of course, sodium stearate, the sodium salt of the fatty acid, is a soap, an example of a soap. So that's been my look at the alkaline hydrolysis of esters, including saponification. The next video in this series takes a look at how we determine the saponification value of a fat or oil. Thanks for listening.